As Karen said, my name is Nate. I'm 1 month into a new company called Proving Ground. So this event kind of comes on that 1 month anniversary, which is just kind of funny and exciting. I had to really curate my deck to try to talk about some of the new things that I'm up to. Happy to be back at USC. I used to live out in Los Angeles here for about 5 or 6 years. Was involved with Karen and Doug here at USC and participated in Seneca Pass, so really happy to be back in Southern California, and I appreciate the invite. Proving Ground is a new company that I started just on the tails of Case. Formerly, I was with a company called Case, based out of New York City, as a director and associate partner there. Case has gone through some transformations. I encourage you to look up what those are. And I have since started this company with an emphasis on enabling a data-driven building industry. And concepts like visual programming and programming in general, automation, computation are essential components of this new venture. And I'm going to be talking very high level about where I think a lot of this stuff is going, where the opportunities are, and where I think you guys can take advantage of this. I'm based out of Omaha, Nebraska, so I don't think anyone here ever been to Omaha, Nebraska. Yes, that is more than I thought. Basically, it's me and my cow, and 14 son. So, Proving Ground really proceeds from a couple of notions. As a professional, as a young professional, I've always been bothered by a couple of things in our industry. The amount of technology that we have, the powerful tools at our disposal. We are operating in a $600 billion. Oh, this is fine. I can see that. I promise I won't trip over myself. I have lasers coming next. And we're done. Any questions? Just kidding. All good fun. I've always been bothered by a couple of things. And I think a lot of this stems from the fact that we have these amazing tools at our disposal, these amazing data, and yet 72% of our projects are over budget. We've got 70% over schedule. We're looking at 39% of carbon emissions coming from buildings, 20% non-industrial waste from buildings. Buildings are slow, expensive, risky. I'm interested in this idea that data is this fast, cheap medium that can provide a level of certainty. And that's where much of my work kind of proceeds from. I don't think data is the answer to everything. I think data and the technology that we have, coupled with a great process, can really help us to move the industry forward. So at the core of my focus, though, is the belief in a data-driven building industry. Now, of course, this event is really about visual programming. And I would say, again, that a lot of my work has visual programming at the core. It really is this thread that weaves its way in through a lot of the solutions that I develop with my clients. But it's a new part of a bigger puzzle. And where I like to frame a lot of my work is really at the intersection of a couple of things. This idea of computation, which I would put kind of visual programming in that bucket. The idea that we're able to automate, create new systems, new workflows, and ideas that stem from this, our ability to customize them and develop our tools with our approach. Simulation, being able to prove ideas early on in the process, be able to prove things before they're built, very powerful notion. Building information modeling, the foundation of our industry at the moment as it relates to design and delivery, and then analytics. So being able to take apart the complexity of our workflow, the data that we have at our disposal, and make sense of it, inform our work, create insight and value for our clients. So a couple of examples. We've got a couple of case studies here, very, very short ones. Again, 1 month in, hopefully there's enough here to latch onto. Data for planning. I mean, I think there's immense opportunities to, this should be one is this one. Trust me, it's really cool. The idea that, you know, through kind of the lightweight creation of various parametric tools, we can start to begin to inform the process early on, begin to get ideas of metrics. Things that, you know, are as simple as very quick massing studies, and begin to derive data out of this, you know, front end of a lot of this work and this data, the process data, we can perform some of these decisions, right sizing your project, understand the problems that are in front of you. And then moving on to later stages of the process, using visual programming, using data-driven process to help develop your design, really kind of take a couple of cues from industrial design, uses of analysis, iterative design to make these, you know, beautiful parametric models that allow us to be very flexible and create buildable solutions, but also solutions that are unique. And this is a unique look at a grasshopper definition without the spaghetti. As much as I love visual programming and things like that, I think spaghetti can sometimes be a problem. And one of the nice things about this is how you can customize your interface to really address the problems that you're actually dealing with. Okay, I'll show this one. So, let's jump out of here.
Have the file, Nathan?
Yeah, I'm looking for it. Half my presentation is animations, which seem to be worth the grade for our book. Once I unplug it.